Hi, and welcome back to our kids' workshop. I will go around here. So, yesterday it didn't went that well with our... I had to put a cork in the hole, or what we shall call it. But we have done that, and it's fine now. So, you can see here, I have to just take this and we will carry on where we left. Oh, some coffee down to the raspy voice, and it's raspy anyway. Sorry. See, so, and what we ended up doing was we was kind of making a kind of at some help when we are gonna make the wheel. So I made this piece of wood, and I cut, and I did this before, I cut this, but to cut this way I had to be able to. So I will go a little down. You can see I glued and screwed a piece of wood down there, and the reason is, show you, often you need to have something that you, that's right, you have, you need to have something you can, this is a very big one, but see, now I can hold it and saw this way. And this table have rounded edges, so I cannot mount anything. A real carpenter bench have something that you can squeeze this in between, so you can. But now we made this little because, and you will see when we are making the wheel to the trebuchet here, this, can you see, yes, this wheel here, you have to saw something round, and I will show you later. But yesterday we did, and here's I will screw it to the table, but you can buy something looks like this, so you can just with a wing nut tie it to a table, but I don't know if you can get them anywhere, everywhere, I mean. So what I did wrong yesterday, I figured out why my hole ended up the wrong place, because I sat this on top of this. And I kind of, there is one here and one there on top of that, so I thought it's the same as this. And what I said also was that, and you can see, and then you put it in the wrong place, so it has to be on top of this one. So to do this, I just put a stick here, and it's the same height as this, is the same height now as this. And I don't know if you can see that close. You can see I have put a, see, whoops, you can see I have put something in the hole, so I put a stick in there, and now I can drill a new hole above, because I couldn't do that otherwise. So, it's a little difficult with the cameras, but it works. So I have put a drill bit in here, and I will go down on my knees. And now, you know, we have to do it directly in. You cannot twist it like that, so you have to be pretty precise with this. I think you can see what I'm doing. And the problem with wood like this is that it is so soft that it easy not to hit the center. So, and that was a thinner drill bit, so we got, because you can see you can see the grain in this, and if the hole has to, the middle of the hole has to be on top of a grain like this, the drill bit wants to slide down and go in between here, because this material is just softer in the top of the hard grain. So that's, if it was another kind of wood, oak or something like that, where the grain are much closer in between, much denser tree, you wouldn't have that problem. But this spruce or what it called, it kind of very easy to drill wrong in, but it's cheap, and that's kind of our goal. And now I want to see how thick our stick is. 5. So we want 5. So there are little room for movement. And I cannot see anything here. 5. This is 1. And this drill bit is not very sharp, but it's the best one I have. In that size, I think I will. Yeah, this is not much better. Need to buy some new ones. Oh, I have another box. I will see if it's better. If there is a 5.5 in there. It is. And a fine one. So, we'll borrow that one. A dull drill bit makes a not that nice hole. So, and now we will go in here and be very careful to do it right. And don't put too much pressure on it. So, and now we will see if we hit the okay. Okay, we need a 6. I'll take this one to see. Wasn't that a 5-5? No, it was not a 5-5. It was a 5. It was put in the wrong place in the box. Who have done that? So, just that half a millimeter thicker. See, now we touch the other side, and that's a very good thing. And even when we put this one on, see? So. I don't know why we did it wrong yesterday, but we did. And I will change the view. Look there, because I will stand in front of it now. Because I will be sure that it's kind of in the right place. We will not make more mistakes if we can help it. So, and the problem, of course, here is that we cannot drill from this side, so we have to turn it around, and have to move this away. And I will do, no. Where is it? Oh, it is it. Ah. It's a little difficult. Because the center of the hole is there. No, it's not. Okay, move it up a little. There. And then the other way. Now we will use our own we'll set that to the same angle. Angle, would I say, because it don't fill that much. Maybe we can use it. We cannot. Even that is too high. Okay. Then we can use something else. We can use, sure. Stick like this. And you can use a piece of paper or something, because this is cut in that angle. So. And now it is the measure. Take a little ruler. Yeah. Please remove all the sticks. This is in the middle here. It is 1, 2, 3, 4 and a half. 1, 2, 3, 4 and a half. Right. Measure twice. Two only wrong ones. So, and then we will have the middle of it this way. And the middle of the stick is here. So, now we know where to drill, and we will start again with a small one, so that we can kind of put it where we want it. And you can hold it like this. Yes. Yes. Up. didn't sound good. But nothing happened. But it sounded like something was happening. See? Are we not lucky? And here we can get the lid on. Because now we can glue those. You see anything here? That hole is very small. Maybe we need to drill that up a little. But the stick can be thicker in this end than in the other end, so. But now there's a little more room for maneuvering. See? Now we have our holes through and our sticks through, and now we can glue these on because the wheels will be around this and this, so now we can make a little stroke, a little line. This. And then we are sure that afterwards we will not have problem with it fitting. So. And I will take my trusted cotton sticks here and see if they're holding this one. And when I'm gluing it, I will put the stick on again through it, because then I know it haven't moved. Oops. A lot of glue. And my trash can. We need that one. And put. Go away. I will just put it loosely here. Put the stick through afterwards. And kind of adjust it a little. I think this stick is a little thick on this end than it was in the other. Now we are pretty sure that it's in its place. got to be 100%. Oops, that was the mic. I will take some of this. See, and then okay, not gonna use those, and this one we are not gonna use at all. I'll take two more to the other side and go over there. They are not holding anything, they are just be sure it's the alignment. Go away. See? So, where are we now? We are like this. The slide. And we are like this, the guy that's gonna hang up here. And so the only thing we miss is the wheels and I don't remember how many there was. I think it was 9, but I can see if I do this, you can just measure the like this, and then you can see how many sticks. 8 sticks. Kind of gone into this because it just 8 of these up on glued together, and then you have a square, and out of that square you make the wheel. So if we make it, or maybe I made it, I made it 9. What I am? Yes, I think I made a 9. That's what I could remember. Yes. Then there is a little to saw off. So, and me, and then 9 pieces. Yes. So, I will move this one over here in the way. So, more room. You know how we, you can see on the other videos how we did this. I just measured and then I cut it with this saw here. Now I had to change the camera again. See. Last time. Or the other times I have just done it like you would do it. Just cut it, measure 9 centimeters, 90 millimeters, and stroke, and then an angle over, and then. But this time I will do it on the machine to get faster done. Right. So we can make wheels next time, and then we only and we need to make 4 crosses in the middle to hold the wheel, and then a small grill sticks in between like this. So and then soon be over, and I hope you have come up with some ideas to new stuff, or haven't you? Or you know, you don't have any, you don't get to say anything if you don't get some ideas, because then they will all be mine. And it could be fun to make something you would like me to do. But it's of course up to you. Because, see, I just make this one so that I have someday I will clean up here. Well, I don't seem to be able to find the time. My grandson was sick today, so he was visiting. But see, now I will move this. Closer, and then we move camera a little. Sorry for this. I don't hope you get seasick. See, everyone can see. I will take some light so I can see why. Clumsy. So then we have some light, right? See, the good part of this is I only have to set the measurement on one, and then all of them will be the same size. because 9 is 9, and we need 4. That's a lot. I will go down here so I can see my note. Oops, not one anywhere yet. So, like this, because now I can adjust this one, and when I have done that, they will all be similar size. It's a whole factory of 9 millimeters. You see, I will hold this one. There's not room for my fingers. Because if I don't, it shoot it. And just so that I hold it. When the end hits the blade, then it and it make a big stents in it, in the stick. So it destroys the stick. See, that's easy. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, that's easier than sawing one at a time. And one more out of the bunch. Oh. Yes, that was how I used to do it. When I was cutting all the stakes to the wolf, I promise you I have these small squares flying all over the room. See? Okay, we'll take a brand new stick. How many? 2, 4, 6, and 7. And never do this at home. Because this will cut your finger, I promise you. Even a little machine like this. It's like slicing bread. Oops. There are, but we will not. You will not play with that close, right? Oops. I caught a trebuchet. So, and we will. Yeah, we can stand here. No, I will move this and then. So, only. See? I need a cameraman and a producer and whatnot. We'll remove this, and I think it's about good enough. And we will go up in the sky. So, and you can. And we will. And this was nice white when we started it, our journey, but it's not that anymore. What's wrong with this? They are not exactly the same, are they? Yes, they are. So. I'm looking for the grain, turning the right way, because then there are no lips. Six, eight. And 9. See? A plate like this. Oh! So, and we always have to, as you remember, yes, and they are so fine, I don't think. None of them have a lot of respect. Oops. So we will stop it. And I will find this one. As you remember, because it has a stick, a border, a lip here, so that it's easier to kind of do like this when we assemble it. I will turn it around because it's easier for me. Maybe not that good for you. Ugh! I keep doing that. So, on here and one. Glue on this side. think we need to fiddle this. Squeeze it more later. Which way is this? Yes. Nope. This way. Some of them are when the grain are kind of diagonal, then it's hard to see when. How it's, which sides are which height. But this was the right one. And this should be the right one. It is. Some of you maybe could think that why am I not just taking one piece of wood and do it instead of this, because you have this this way, see, you have this the grain in it, it looks totally different. So you wouldn't have that if you just took a piece of grain and, or one border or one plank or what you would call it, and did it in that way. Don't be, yes. Then it will be different. And then I couldn't get this. They didn't have any 9mm if I wanted it, but I guess I could get it somewhere. But I prefer this because it looks nicer, and a lot of this is looked. The goal is to get it to look like it did. As much as possible as it did when they used it back in the time in the Middle Ages. Because you have to understand, this is so big that the wheels are so big that there are people are running around in it, inside it, to wheel up the heavy stuff. In full size, it would be able to throw a car up in the other end of the field. So it's kind of a little heavy stuff. And then tomorrow we will start to make the wreaths. The rest of these I will make before we get on tomorrow evening, because you can kind of see how it is here. There's no special in that. Everyone can participate. And then we only have to make the long arm. And some small stuff. So, and we will take one of these and squeeze it a little. Press down on it so it and if you could, it would be helpful to you to make a little thing like this. Then don't make it in the same the sticks has to be a little smaller than the other sticks. Where do I have? You can see these sticks are... No, that's not the right one. They are 6x6. I have it somewhere in the mess. Here. You can see this stick is much... here the camera. This stick is much smaller than this. You can see the difference. And that means if you have put too much glue on, somehow it's kind of glued to this border here. Then you just take a stick like this, hold against, and then hold it up like this, and then give it a yank with a hammer. I cannot do it now, but. Yeah, just give it a yank and then it. But if it was the same height, then you couldn't get at it. So that's why I will show you tomorrow what I mean. But you know, I'm very careful with the glue. But maybe you are a little more generous. But don't be too generous with it, because that will cause you a lot of problems. Needless problems. So, but I think that was everything for today. event. We will carry on again tomorrow, and I will have made 4 of those tomorrow evening, so that you can see how you, oops, that was, how you can, and then I'll demonstrate how to saw them out with help of the camera. I always choose them on camera. With help of this, and what's the magic there is about this piece of wood here. So I will say thank you, because in a quarter I will get on with a new show, some Christmas Santa's workshop. But if you get a good idea to what we can make, say it on the chat. Go into pixelfantasies.com and then just give some idea. Or if you have any questions about anything, just ask and I will answer you. I have made the chat for the same reason, so we can help each other get the result we want. So I will say thank you and for joining me, and see you again tomorrow. Bye bye.